That was great. Day 8. We survived the horde night. We also killed a lot of zombies and got a lot of loot. Let's just pick it up real fast. We gained 5 levels. I put it into looting. We'll talk some more about Navascane later in the video. As for now, we'll just see the results of Fortnite. Okay, let's see how much damage we took. The stair looks okay. Yeah, fine. Hatch took a lot of damage, but that's normal. Also this part. Yeah, looks fine. We killed them pretty fast, so there's no extra damage anywhere else. Okay, looks okay, just a little bit. And there's one more spot we need to check. This one over here always takes damage. The zombies sometimes frenzy and they just hit this part. Okay. Now, if you don't have the materials or the time, you can spend Horde Night up somewhere safe. This is Crackerbook. I just chose it because that one of the buildings I knew was good enough. But there are much better buildings than this one. So I'll just use a save game and stay up here and look at the Horde, trying to get to me. And when the day is done, I'll just jump down and you can see all the damage. That they have done. They can't reach me, so they're trying to destroy the walls to bring the building down, but they can't do that in one night. So if you do this and you try to do it one more night, then you should go somewhere up high. But of course, if a vulture comes, you have to fight it. But this is forest, so the odds are pretty low at this level. Okay, and Horde Night is soon over, and I'll jump down and you can see the damage. Okay, jump down and watch. Now, as you recall, we never went into Wasteland except that part where we tried desperately to get out of it. Wasteland is a horrible place to be. The trader actually sent me on the quest here on day, I think, 4. And I had to reject it because it would be horrible. This is day 8 and I should not be doing it now. I should wait until 3 weeks maybe. It's not appropriate for this level. But I think I just finished the series by, I guess, dying in Wastelands. So, that's an experience for you. So you can see there's waste everywhere, big holes in the road, there's lots of creatures around. Vultures, dogs, bears. There's some zombies you don't want to run into, like the mutant zombies and the demolishers and that, I don't know, science zombie, I don't know what name. Anyway, it's not a good place to be. I'm going to take you to that spot over there and show you the insights of tier 7. That's a bear. Okay, another way. Try this way instead. And there's another bear. Okay, just gun it and we'll see what happens. Zombie bears are more aggressive than normal bears, so I guess we'll be safe. That's just a normal bear. Okay, this is second level. Okay, third level. Yes. Not getting any easier. But after this, there will be a section where it's not so bad. radiated zombie here. Okay, this is really bad. That's the guy I told you about. He's very strong. Hard to kill. Regain my stamina. Because he died. That's a perk from spears. Getting closer to the end. Okay, this is the final room. I have no more spears, I can't repair. Just had a scrappy gun. I will die in here. I'm shooting in. Just watch how bad it is. This is the end room of a tier 7. That's it. Yeah, so that was Navisken gameplay. I will not play any more on this map. I think it's small and boring compared to the other maps I usually play. I'll teach you more about that later. Overall, it was a pretty good game, I think. We got lucky at times and unlucky on day 4. It's just one day of unluck, so I think we can be proud that we made it this far. And I'll see you on the next map. Yeah, you can see that building is where we died, way up there. That's quite an achievement. Yeah, I'll see you on the next play. Okay, so now this is the map over Navisken. We started here. This is Teddy Joel. He gave us quests for this area here. And he also sent us around the forest biome in general here. And on day 2 he gave us a bike and shifted us off to Teddy Jen down here in the burnt forest biome. Which he gave us quests for that area and also for this burnt city, as I call it. We did a lot of quests in here and we also spent some nights and also built a base on day 6. This biome is pretty boring though, so I would build a base somewhere else maybe. Okay, and we have Deersville here with a tier 5 hospital. It's one of the best tier 5s on this map. And there are Crackerbrook here, which is an important BOI. And this is the farm. We spent one night here as well. I actually built a base there sometime. Yeah, this hospital, you'll get a lot of quests. For there are only 5-6 tier 5s on this map, I think. It's not a lot. So still you'll get this one from the closest traders. There are 3 traders that are close. Okay, in the desert, there's where is it? There? There's a trader there or there, I'm not really sure. Used to be there. Well, anyway. So the city here, Deception or Perception, I don't remember. But anyway, you get quests from him to go down here. This city is pretty big. It has 2 tier 5s. One is Crackerbrook Headquarters, which is a really good tier 5. But the problem is getting across. As you can see, it has a big river. There's a broken bridge here. I actually rebuilt it one time and just motorcycled across. If you don't have a gyrocopter. That's the problem with the desert, is getting across to the city when you have a quest for the city. I I don't know why they did this. I would redo it if it was the Fun Pimps who made this game. This is a snow biome. That's a bit harder than the forest. I mean, yeah, the forest also, but also the desert. The trader is used to be here, I think. Where is he now? I think he's here. That's pretty good though, because it's so close to the city. So it's easy to get to the close city. I don't remember that name either. But the city is very close, as you can see. So you can take a quest there and just go in here and do the quest. So you don't have to travel so much like the other traders we've been to. Although we will get a motorcycle eventually. Moving down, there is the wastelands. You can see there are several, well, cities. There's only one really big city, but I would say they are big enough to be called cities, all of them. There's a trader in between them, Trader Rekt, down here. He is a horrible trader that makes wasteland even worse than it already is. He only gives you crap, like seeds. Though if you are going into farming, it's probably very good for you. I'm not very familiar with these three cities. Gravestone. I don't remember the names. There are some tier 5s, very few. That's the problem with Navskan, it's very few tier 5s in general. There's one tier 5 there. And where were we? There is one. That's where we died. Now about Navskan in general, it's a medium map. It's not very good for beginners, I would say. I don't know why they put this as default. The good thing about Navskan, you get the best traders very early. But it's a medium map. This is a big map. You see how big these cities are. Every white dot is a building. This is Yakubi territory, I already told you about. And compared to Navskan, this is so much easier to have so many POIs in one city. Makes everything so much cooler and easier. Not easier though, because they have their own problems. You can see how big such a city is. And yeah, I guess I'll see you there. This is where we're going eventually. And I hope you enjoyed Navskan. See you in Yakubi.